My name's Dr. Greg Buck. I'm one of the family practice physicians at Bremen BMG Medical Group, and have been working in Bremen for several years in family practice. Usually we're looking for changes in the skin, such as newer lesions, lesions that are getting larger, possibly irregular borders, and the skin maybe get sort of raised or rough or irritated, sometimes increasing color with redness or erythema, sores or wounds that don't tend to heal and just seem to be chronic, and they don't have to be painful, they can be painless lesions. Some people will have, you know, moles or nevi for several years and feel that they're fine. And then all of a sudden the lesion may start to change over the course of, you know, 3 months or something like this. And they're starting to notice that it's getting raised, rough. The border gets irregular, may change colors, or you're getting multi-different colors in the lesion. And that tends to be more warning signs that we have to worry about. If a sore lesion doesn't heal or starts to bleed, then we usually become a little more concerned about those lesions and or spots over a period of time. We'd like patients to talk to their primary care providers relatively soon if they have a new lesion or spot that they're concerned about. That's so that we can look at that and get an idea of what it looks like, and also if it does appear to be something that we're concerned about, we can do things such as a biopsy or an excision, and it'll be a lot easier to do that when the lesion is smaller as opposed to waiting for it to get larger or bigger. Long-term effects of sun damage on skin can cause multiple problems, such as, you know, skin cancers, but also even things like wrinkles or causing the skin to become more rough, irritated, red, may get sort of age or spots that people will get from the chronic sun damage or exposure that people will get over the years. It can become cumulative and then eventually put you at higher risk for things like skin cancers, melanomas, squamous cell cancer, and basal cell carcinoma. Things you can do to prevent further sun damage are things such as, unfortunately, avoiding the sun or being out maybe during the peak hours where the sun is more prominent. Trying to make sure you wear long sleeve shirts or hats, even sunglasses to protect more your face. Make sure you keep your ears covered up. Sort of broad rimmed hats will help. And then also just sunscreen to try to decrease your exposure to the ultraviolet light that's causing this sun damage and putting you at risk for skin cancers. There are different types of sunscreens, but basically if you want something that's probably has an SPF over 30, higher sunscreens will help some, but they don't get quite as much benefit as the higher you go. There are a few things. Usually I have most of the dermatologists evaluate people for that, but they can sometimes do some dermabrasions or chemical treatments with certain medications or retinoic acids to try to remove some of the layers of skin. Sometimes they will use lasers or other treatments to try to remove some of the damaged skin to try to prevent it from becoming worse. You can sometimes also have small lesions that you can remove with, you know, electrocautery or cryotherapy, and to try to prevent these lesions from further developing into skin cancers or worse lesions. And then if they become larger or more aggressive, such as cancer, such as melanoma, squamous cell carcinomas, and basal cell carcinomas, then I'm usually doing excisions of those lesions with a margin to try to prevent those from recurring. Beacon primary care providers are here to treat your medical conditions. Please contact beaconhealthsystem.org to schedule an appointment with your primary care physician.